The last topic this week is an introduction to weather and climate. These are two terms that you have undoubtedly heard and used in general conversation. Sometimes, however, the terms are used incorrectly. Thus, let's first start with definitions. Weather is the short-run atmospheric conditions that exist for a given time in a specific area. Climate, on the other hand, is a summation or aggregate of day-to-day weather conditions over a long period of time. Thus, weather deals with conditions for a specific short period of time in a specific place, and climate is generally more of a long-term aggregate. For example, the climate here in Northern California is very warm, dry, and mild, but the weather may be rainy or cold on a specific day. The four elements of weather and climate are the basic components of weather and climate. To remember them, some students find it useful to simply consider a hypothetical weather report. Imagine the weather reporter saying, "Today the high temperature will be 68 degrees. There is a low pressure system coming in, and winds will be approximately 10 miles per hour from the west. So thus we can expect rainfall this afternoon or evening of up to about 1.5 inches. You get the idea. The four major elements of weather and climate, which you need to know, are temperature, pressure, wind, and moisture content. Later in the course, we'll be going over each of these in much more detail. Next, there are seven controls of weather and climate. The controls of weather and climate are the factors that can strongly impact and thus control the elements of weather and climate. Each of the controls shown here strongly impacts one or more of the four elements. For example, latitude is the strongest control of temperature. You knew that. If I asked you to name somewhere warm on Earth, you'd probably name somewhere near the equator. If I asked you to name somewhere cold, you'd likely name the North Pole or Antarctica, somewhere very far from the equator. Notably, latitude also affects pressure, wind, and moisture content. And we'll study this later in the course. Your text does a good job of introducing these controls. Importantly, take a few minutes right now to review the textbook explanation of each control so that you could give either a general or specific example of how each control affects one or more of the elements of weather and climate. At this point, it may be easiest to focus on temperature, but you can consider pressure, moisture content, or wind as well. Again, go to your textbook and review these seven controls. We're going to be spending considerable time on them in the next chapter as well.